that.
Do you have someone recording me?
Sorry, okay, perfect.
Alright, many of us have pets, whether it be a dog or a cat or one of the other pets from the long list of animals that people keep. And I have before at a time connected more with my pets than other people. And the reason I did that was because I felt a lot more safer with them, or I felt like I was in a warm environment. But what I did not realize was this was actually a form of animal assisted therapy, which is a therapy is a animal assisted therapy is a form of therapy that uses animals as a form of treatment for people to help with social skills, depression, and many other things. So it can either be used with just a pet with the person's help, a child or an adult, you know, create social skills or just feel safer, as well as with a therapist in order to help them become more active in their sessions as well as feel more comfortable. And I believe the more you learn about animal assisted therapy, the more you'll realize how much these pets impact our lives. So first I'm going to talk about the psychological effects that they have, as well as the physical, and then the drawbacks that animal assisted therapy can have. So as I said, animal assisted therapy can help anyone regardless of age, sex, or race, because depression can take a hold of anyone. And as author Melinda Stanley Herman stated in the American Journal of Nursing in October 2005, that most studies that support the psychological benefits of animal assisted therapy indicate an increase in relaxation as evidenced by a reduction in blood pressure and heart rate. This means that the therapy actually has a soothing effect on people, so it keeps them more relaxed. So patients who were before a lot more troublesome for the therapist to deal with, now that they have a pet with them, they can feel more calm and feel just easier to open up with the therapist. And now that I've talked about the psychological effects, I can go into the physical benefits. And it could be many physical benefits, which can either be health improving or life saving. Because heart failure is one of the most deadly and common reasons adults are hospitalized in the US, and nearly 1 million of them are put into the hospital with heart failure as a reason. And as author Katie M. Cole stated in the American Journal of Critical Care, November 2007, animal assisted therapy improves cardiopulmonary pressures, neuroforming levels, and anxiety in patients hospitalized with heart failure. That means that animal assisted therapy really helps patients with heart failure because it helps keep their blood pressure down, their heart rate down, and helps keep them in a healthy, stable condition, as well as helping other people who have never had heart failure stay healthy in order to never have something like heart failure occur to them. And now that I've talked about the psychological and physical benefits, I can go into the negative implications that it has, which can be many. And the main cause of this is usually negligence, because as author Jay Sittery wrote in the Cambridge University Press on January 2004, he wrote about a woman who came into the hospital with fever, chills, and regular abdominal pain. She had been going through dialysis for about 3 years, but even then, when she came in, the doctors could not figure out why she was ill until she told them about her therapy kit that she kept and who would lick her hands before and during her fluid cycle for her dialysis, as well as possibly biting and leaking the tubing for her medical clinic, which caused an infection that was passed on from the cat from an infection called Pasteurisata multicauda, which estimated 66% of dogs and 90% of cats carry. That means this could also be passed through to another person through a bite. So either through bad taking care of the pets or just bad training on the part of the people who need to train the animals, the animals can end up causing more hurt than actually helping. So in conclusion, I talked about the physical effects as well as the psychological, and bad side, the psychological being that the pets have a soothing effect on people, helping them go through their stresses a lot better, as well as the physical benefits, which were lowering heart rate and blood pressure for people who had heart failure, or just keeping people healthy in general, as well as the bad side of it, which can be caused by bad training for the animals, which can lead to biting and causing infections, which would be a lot worse than causing help for the about animal-assisted therapy, the more you will realize that these animals have a great impact on our lives. And I hope that the next time you look at your own pets, that you realize they impact your life a lot more than you.